Hi, I'm Dr. Vidyadhara S, Head of the Department and Consultant Spine Surgeon at Manipal Hospitals, Bangalore. It is usually the sideward bend of the spine which is called as scoliosis, and that was very gross to begin with, but nowadays we believe that it's a three-dimensional deformity. It is not just the sideward bend, it's also rotation and also the loss of backward bend. So it is commonly seen in children. When we say that there is no specific cause, then it is called as idiopathic. It is the commonest. Maybe it constitutes about 80% of scoliosis. It can be present because of birth defects in the bones of the vertebrae, and then it is called as congenital. Or it may be neuromuscular, like patients with problems with the nerves or muscles developing paralysis of hands and legs, and also the pelvic muscles developing a bend in the back, which is called as neuromuscular scoliosis. Or degenerative, wherein with aging, elderly people getting a bend in the back because of aging process, which is in excess or in accelerated nerve, is again a cause. And lastly, iatrogenic. Following surgeries or interventions done by doctors, the patient developing a bend in the back is the last one. Let me talk briefly about the commonest, that is the adolescent idiopathic scoliosis, which constitutes to 80%. See, this typically happens in the girls between the age group of 10 to 15 years, and it is a painless condition. It goes unnoticed, whereas in the West there is a school screening program in which they ask the child to bend forwards, and the doctor or the paramedic look at the scapula, the rib hump, if it is there, then they are taken for an x-ray, and x-ray can detect a scoliosis. Usually less than 10 degrees is not scoliosis. 10 to 25 degrees of bend, we keep the child under observation. If it is between 25 degrees to 45 degrees, we give a brace to the child so that it prevents progression. And if it is more than 45-50 degrees, the child needs a surgery. Now, this is a completely preventable problem. If you detect it early, it can be braced so that the need for surgery can be prevented. And the next commonest that we see is the degenerative scoliosis. An elderly person having a stoop either forward or sideways is again common, but this is very painful. And patient develops more and more back pain on change of posture, and also tingling numbness in the lower limbs and heaviness of lower limbs on prolonged standing and walking. Now, this again can be treated if patient develops deficits or weakness of lower limbs or bowel bladder involvement, or if the pain is more than 3 months. Definitely the benefit of surgery is a big thing. If patient medical condition doesn't allow us to get a surgery done in this patient, we can always intervene by way of some spinal injections like facet block or transforaminal epidural injection, and so on.